Hi guys, so this video is going to be about potty training.
Yeah.
I'm not supposed to be in this video, but I'm inside because I also help potty train. Yeah.
It's fine, lady, it's fine. All right, so we've been getting a lot of questions from a lot of people about potty training, and unfortunately, they always contact me when it's almost too late. Because that's when they realize that, look, my baby has been potty training for... I've been trying to potty train my baby for so long and it's not working. And that's when they now come to me and go like, oh, how did you do the potty training thing? And hey, we're going to share all our tips because we had techniques we used that really worked for us. And you'd love this video, trust me. So let's get back to it.
So the first thing to note when you're potty training is that it's possible.
Yeah,
it's possible.
Yeah,
she'll add the rest.
When you're potty training, you start as soon as the child starts walking. Mm-hmm. That's the best time to start potty training, because at that time, they just realize that, hey, my legs can actually work like my parents' legs, and I'm on my feet. Hey, like, this is exciting, and they love to walk all over and everything. If you are the stay home kind of mom, or if there's someone else with your kids at home, let them rip the babies off diapers, because that's what gets them comfortable and they don't want to stop using the diapers if they are always in diapers.
And you know, if the diapers are off, be prepared to clean.
Yeah, like, yeah, it's gonna get messy.
If you have carpets in your house, I think you should get rid of all the carpets and all those
towels,
things, because it's gonna get messy.
Yeah,
that's the thing. Yeah.
If your towels are too slippery, you don't have to worry too much, because children are actually more intelligent than we think. Yeah, babies. A one-year-old child who knows that, hey, this place is very slippery, I can fall down at any time, they become cautious. Yeah, you see that they are walking with some kind of... They know what to do, really. So it's not going to get too dangerous. And if they should fall a couple of times, they are not going to die, really.
They go through situations like that. They actually
remember that.
Hey, last time I fell down.
I fell down when I wee-weed on the floor. I fell down, so I have to be careful. And really, children don't even like it when they wee-wee on themselves. They pee on themselves, or when they poo-poo on themselves, they don't like it. And what actually does the trick is the reaction of you, the parents.
Mm.
Okay, your reaction really matters. You're not supposed to cane the child, beat the child when the child poops. I mean, it's a natural thing, really. So you're not supposed to, because it can get really overwhelming when you're a new mother, especially when you're a new mother. And in my situation, I had a baby right after the first baby. So I was really stressed. I mean, going through parenting without help in the house. I have to do all the cleaning, all the cooking. I was into ministry, running businesses. Everything was on me. So it got very, very overwhelming at times. And when the child poo-poos, when a two-year-old poo-poos, when she knows she's not supposed to poo-poo herself, she's supposed to just go straight to the potty, it can get really like, seriously, you know you're supposed to go to the potty, just go to the potty.
It's frustrating.
Yes, but I never beat the child because of poo-poo. It's never done, okay, or wee-wee. But your reaction does the trick. Hey, why did you just poop on the floor? Hey, it's not done. Hey, don't do that again. Like, that kind of thing. So the child begins to, like, okay, mommy always reacts when I poop on the floor. And I really don't like it either. So why not try this potty thing? Okay.
Yeah.
And when they start walking, immediately they start walking. That's somewhere around 1 year. For some children, it's 1 year, 5 months. Yeah, they start walking. They're taking steps. Around that time, just don't wear the diapers at home. You're going out, you can wear diapers. But when you're at home, try to just wear a panty or boxer shorts for the boys. Just let them feel free. Let air pass around
Let them feel free, really.
And there are some children who also don't like to sit on the potty. And we had one of those. Trust me.
Elikem
would never sit on the potty. Never ever, he never sat on the potty, so it was very dicey trying to potty train him. And he didn't talk early too. Nona talked very early. It was easy for her to express herself, and she could understand us too. So when we told her what the potty does, she's like, oh, okay. So with the potty, I don't have to poo-poo myself, and it was really easy for her to just grasp things and just conform to what we were telling her to do.
Children actually understand.
Yeah, they do. They do. Don't undermine your babies.
They will not understand. Yeah, but they do.
Don't think that, oh, they're babies, they don't really understand what I'm saying. Look, they've been hearing you talk since they were in the womb. Yeah. So language is not really new to them, really. It's just hard for them to express themselves sometimes, but they understand every single thing you're saying.
Exactly.
But Eliken never sat on the potty. So when he was two, I decided that, look, we're going to go straight to the WC, if that's what she wants. And he was tall, like, Eliken is naturally a tall guy. So he whenever he sat on the potty, I can see that, look, the guy is not, he's not comfortable. So it's better I just take him off it. And we went straight to the WC when he was two, and he started using it sometimes. And then he got used to it. Yeah, I mean, he didn't even cross 2 years, 2 months, and then he had potty trained. Yeah. And there's this other issue with night potty training. Because the night one is where it gets really difficult.
You have to wake up.
It is possible, actually. It is also possible. And my mother-in-law showed me this trick for the night potty training. God bless her so much. She's been such a wonderful mother. God bless you, mommy. Yeah, so she taught me that in the night, if you want your child to be fully potty trained, especially for the night one, where the child actually knows when she wants to wee-wee in the night, she wakes up on her own and goes to wee-wee in the potty on her own. If you want to do that, it's difficult, but she taught me how to do it. She said that I'd have to wake up in the night, maybe multiple times in the night. Yes, and it really worked. I remember Yaya potty trained when she was 1 year 7 months, my last born.
Mm-hmm.
1 year 7 months, and at that time I was like, I just want her to also know how to do the night one too. So even in the night, we don't wear diapers. That was what we're doing. We're wearing diapers for her. And when I see that she's moving, because they sleep like maybe 2 hours intermittently. So after 2 hours, you realize that she's moving on the bed. Like,
she wants to
That's an indication that she wants to really. So I just take her off. Then the potty is nearby, and then I just put her on it and kind of like wake her up a bit for her to know that she's actually wee-weeing in the middle of the night. Okay, and we did that several times. It would disturb my sleep most of the time. And I'm not a deep sleeper. So as soon as I feel the movement, she used to sleep by me. So as soon as I felt the movement, I would just wake her up and put her on the potty, and then she would just wee-wee and go back to sleep. And someone also complained to me that when her child wakes up in the middle of the night, that is it till morning. That one is also another thing. I don't know what to do about that one, you know, really. But let the kids go to bed tired and don't wake up in the night. Let them go to bed tired. If it's a 1 year old or 2 year old, I'm sure they might have played and at that time their sleep, afternoon sleep, is actually being reduced little by little, so it gets better really. They'll be able to sleep throughout the night, but by that time also you'd have probably stopped breastfeeding, so it would have been better. Okay, I mean, childbearing is really, it gets better as the children grow. It gets better and better and better. And you realize that you're not so as stressed and frustrated as you were when you were a fresh mother.
Mothers, encouragement to you. It gets better.
Okay? Yeah, it gets better.
Fathers, it gets better. No more diapers. Because for me, it's like, I felt like every time we are buying diapers, mm-hmm. I'm just throwing away money. Mm-hmm. Like, literally, because we remove the diaper, we throw it away. I was like, okay, is there a faster way for them to learn how to potty train?
Yeah.
And so we started putting these things to work, and truly too, it worked.
Yeah. Our finances at that time didn't allow us to just buy diapers all the time. I mean, just didn't want to use so much money on buying diapers. We could use that money for something else. And mostly because we are both business-minded. Yeah, so hey, this is the potty training video you guys have been waiting for. If you liked it, remember to share with other mothers who need this information so that they also don't buy so many diapers before their kids are two. Yes, because some children go to like 3, 4, and they're still wearing diapers.
I've seen a 5-year-old wearing diapers.
It's really, really sad.
So I was like, why? Like, why is it? I thought there was maybe something was wrong with the child
No. It's just because they got comfortable, and the parents are also comfortable.
Exactly. Yes. You don't want your house to be messy.
Messy. Yeah. I mean, it's It's difficult. Yeah. Mopping the wee, the pee, and then cleaning up the poo-poo. But that is what does the trick. The child doesn't like to wee-wee on themselves, poo-poo on themselves when there's no diaper. So they'll find a more convenient one, which is the potty.
Exactly.
Yeah, but if you keep the diaper on, it ain't gonna work, baby. Yeah, so that's just it.
The blessing is in the dirt.
Yes. Yeah, so
get in.
Hey, let us know how for other mothers who had other techniques, please comment in the comment section below. Let other mothers and other parents see what worked for you too, so that they can draw tips and inspiration to make their parenting journey easy. Okay?
Sure.
All right.